will be held there. The expo aims to effectively provide schools with collaborative and engaging platforms where ICT experts, influencers and thought leaders from education, business and civic society sectors share their knowledge, expertise, insight and insecurity and connectivity. Now to explain this further, we are joined by Daniel Mathibe, a social entrepreneur and ICT social activist in schools education. Good morning, sir, and welcome to AM News.
Good morning, man. How are you doing?
I'm all right. No complaints. Explain to us briefly, what does eSchool Connectivity and Security Expo is about?
No, fantastic, man. What we're trying to do is that we have invited all sorts of stakeholders in education. Mm-hmm. We have invited business. We've invited stakeholders from the governing body. We've invited civic society. What we looked at, we surveyed the system. Banyanzale Suvi has introduced the most phenomenal system ever in education, which is paperless. Mm. So us as activists, what we came up with when we looked at the education system, we picked up that the level of understanding and advocacy in terms of what ICT is doing and the role of paperless in the society, there is no a proper advocacy out there. Mm. So the ICT, the expo in overall, it's an engaging platform for all these stakeholders to engage. Mm-hmm. You know, we want to share case studies. We want to engage with business to show us an innovation solution that we can introduce into the market. Mm-hmm. In the interim, while we will be creating sort of opportunities for young people, mm-hmm. you know, to venture into the education market and study that the education market to see what kind of opportunities which they exist and then where they can, you know, tap in into the sector. So in a nutshell, what we're trying to achieve about the expo is that we want to, you know, introduce the strategy on how to alleviate challenges in connectivity and security in school education. You know, so we want to usher them into the whole methodology and strategy in place to say these are the ABCD methods that, you know, we have as activists to say we believe that, you know, they can be a solution to alleviate. Because you tend to look at the system now, you know, people, you know, they tend to make a joke of what ICT is in school education. Mm. And it's a game changer. Trust me, it's a game changer. You know, that's where the world is going. That's where, you know, the future is.
Go into deeper details on it being a game changer. What do you mean by that?
Look, currently, you know, South Africa, we are being faced by a monster of the rate of unemployment, you know, and then you look at the most dominating sector in terms of employability, it's ICT and digital, you know. So I think, you know, the Department of Education and our Honorable Panyanzale Sufi has introduced the most phenomenal system, you know, where, you know, employers currently, you know, they are migrating into digital. You know, even corporate now, everything, you know, it's being migrated into digital. The current economic climate that the country is facing now, it has led to budget cuts, you know. So digital and ICT is the future. If we get these learners grilled in an early stage, you know, of school education, you know, it becomes very much interesting for them to venture into a number of opportunities which they exist in ICT and digital. You know what I mean?
Now, speaking of ICT and digital, you spoke about paperless classrooms and the likes. But now we're also faced with the challenges of educators that also need to be taken on board in order to understand and be able to impart that knowledge to the student. Or to the learners. Now, how do we deal with that? Because in most cases, we know that teachers that are out there are people who've already been in the system for quite a while. So for them to be able to share such and take in new information and share with these learners, it's something that's going to be a challenge, wouldn't you say?
Absolutely. But I think from where the vision of the whole thing, how we trying to structure it, it's why we're calling out a collaborative engaging platform. We're pulling out, you know, stakeholders from all sorts of divisions and structures of government. We're pulling out stakeholders from professional teacher development component. We're pulling out private sector. We're pulling out civic society business. You know, they will be rendering different types of expertise and skills, you know, to empower, to impact in these teachers. You know, there's a quite of a number of structure with GDE they have in place. You know, we're working also very close to Metho Guniwe. It's the training arm for the Gauteng Department of Education. You know, so and even us as activists, we've been very much involved in terms of you know, extending a helping hand with the department. You know, to try to equip our educators to integrate into ICT, to try to integrate them to understand, you know, the whole technology and how to render lessons in an e-digital, in an e-lesson, in an e-space way. You know what I mean? So there's quite a lot of involvement in terms of partnership as it concerns, and also in terms of stakeholders in the education business. You know,
share with us the link between ICT and school education.
Wow, that is marvelous. You know, ICT, ever since it's been introduced, we have seen quite, you know, a number of things changing in school education. We have seen you know, the use of tablets. We have seen, you know, the use of interactive boards. We have seen, you know, our young people, you know, they started, there's a hunger now, there's a passion for ICT, you know. So it's not just, you know, something that is being dumped there. It's something that is, it's adding value into the society. It's bringing, change, you know. It's creating opportunities in terms of business. It's creating opportunities in terms of to alleviate the rate of unemployment, you know. So it's quite a very lucrative component that school education is having currently. But we need the level of understanding of stakeholders to understand that it is not a monster. It's something that they need to celebrate. Something that they need to cherish, that, you know, this is the future. The thinking, the advocacy, we need that into to be into place. We cannot compromise that. There should be a proper change management structure in place.
Looks like there's a lot of information that will be available at the expo.
Yes.
Share with us what kind of information will be available at the expo, and when will the expo run from, and for how many days?
Look, we've got it. It's a one-day show. It will be staged at the 5th of July in the capital city, Pretoria. All right, and we've invited quite a number of solution providers. That we're going to have, you know, solutions. We're going to have, you know, partners from different entities, you know, showcasing, you know, case studies, showcasing and innovative solutions in security and connectivity, you know. And then we like to extend this invite, you know, to all the security giants, to the connectivity giants in the ICT space, you know, that, you know, come out there, you know, come and show us your critical thinking, come and show us innovation. That's what we need, you know, to alleviate, to empower education, to empower the sector.
So those who might be interested in coming forward, how can they get hold of you? How do they get there?
Look, the entire show is being coordinated by Signal Secure Technologies. We've got the domain name in place. Everyone who is interested to set foot as an exhibitor or a delegate or a young entrepreneur, you know, they can log on to our domain. It's www.signalsecure.co.za. That's the domain name of the entity piloting the whole thing. And then also, you know, they can get in touch with our office on 012-753-8110. And then, you know, the primary cell number they can call for more information on the participation, on how they can better the system. They can also get in contact with us on 076-201-0002, you know. Those are the key primary contact details.
So it looks like it's going to be a hive of activity there. Is this the only, this would be, of course, the first expo you're having. Are you likely going to expand it and maybe even going forward, take it to the other part of the country?
Absolutely, man. The future projection of the initiative, it's overwhelming. We're looking at talking to you know, provinces like, you know, the Western Cape, provinces like Mpumalanga, Limpopo, Free State. We want to introduce it to, you know, all across, you know. We want to take it as a national initiative, you know. So the future projection, you know, we want to, in the 3-year period, the vision is for the vision of 2030. We want by 2030, you know, education, it has to be on par. you know, we don't want to compromise ICTs in our schools. So the future projection of the whole initiative, there's a rollout plan in place that we will be taking it in all other provinces as well. Mm-hmm. We'll be, you know, knocking different doors of departments, you know, with this kind of mandate, pledging for support.
Are you planning to expand it outside of our country, or for now you're focusing on at least expanding it nationally?
No, look, absolutely. We're looking at, you know, to partner with, you know, to take it also in Africa as well. Mm-hmm. You know, we're looking at to partner with countries in Kenya, you know, in Namibia, in Tanzania. We're looking at, you know, some sort of African partnership as well, in terms of, you know, what we can bring as activists. You know, what we think that it's a solution, you know, to add value to the education system, and then, you know, to create more opportunities for young people to venture into the ICT space in terms of as much as it concerns entrepreneurship, you know. So we feel that, you know, there's a lot to be chewed. There's a lot of opportunities. Mm. So we're extending our wing, and then we're calling out for support as well. We're pledging for support. We're calling out, you know, for support from the CETAs, business, private business, you know, all sorts of entities in the country to come on board, you know, to come on board and support education.
Are you molding this around experiences that maybe you've observed abroad, or it's something that purely we as South Africans or you as activists, it's something that you're coming up with?
Look, what we have done through my research, I spend a lot of time in school education more than anything. You know, I've run a survey of this kind of an initiative before it can even get to be produced, to be put into paper. You know, this is something our findings and research, we as activists, that we have come up with to say, look, this is where education is currently. And then what can be done to alleviate this kind of challenges? You know, we've got ABCD strategy in place. The department mandate is this one. But what's the level of involvement of other stakeholders to cement that vision, to give it color, to make sure that advocacy is well out there, it's prepped, and then there's a proper awareness in terms of everything. So this is something that we spend time. It took me two to three years to get it to this far, you know, to research, to find out, to say, you know, security in our school, it's a major issue now. It's a major issue. You know, it pains me a lot. It breaks my heart to see that we still have learners that they sell tablet devices for a living. You know, we've got that kind of a situation in schools. We've got parents, you know, which they are not involved. They don't understand the significance of ICT in schools. It's why we're saying we're pulling back again, we're bringing them as a stakeholder from the SGB component to say, let them be more involved, you know. So we cannot keep on passing the buck. You know, we cannot keep on passing the buck. I think enough said in the country. We've been having a lot of engagements. It's time we put some action plan into detail and execute, you know. So Daniel, there's quite a lot to be done on the education market. And then, you know, we like to celebrate, you know, all the partners which they've been supportive towards the sector. You know, we acknowledge, we celebrate them. You know, they've been supporting the education business and the education market quite substantially. Partners like Intel Education, Pearson Southern Africa, Macmillan Education, Via Africa, Belela Communications, you know, we celebrate them. Axitech, you know, we celebrate them. They've supported this sector so much. And I pray to God that, you know, it becomes something that they do frequently. They shouldn't give up on you know, pledging support, Daniel, in this sector, my guy.
From this conversation that we've just had, yes, I feel like I'm already at the expo. Thanks a lot.
Fantastic, man.
Thanks a lot for coming through.
Fantastic.
That was Daniel Mathibedi, of course, a social entrepreneur and ICT social activist in school education, talking to us about the e-schools connectivity and the security expo. Do stay with us. AM News continues after this break.